Latin American countries are blessed with natural wealth and majestic landscapes, but it is also riddled with poverty and inequality brought about by many years of bad governments. Dictatorships, revolutions, and populist leaders have often made good governance impossible in Latin America. Their efforts are dedicated to stay in power at the expense of the solution of the social and economic problems of their countries. Crime runs high in these regimes. In Venezuela today, more than 12,000 men and women are killed violently every year, many of them at the hands of government police forces. Of the 10 world countries with most kidnappings during 2007, 5 were Latin American: Venezuela, Mexico, Colombia, Haiti, and Brazil. The main reason for the recent increase in Venezuela kidnappings is the effective anti-terrorist campaign of the Colombian government, combined with Venezuelan President Chavez's alignment with the Colombian terrorist group of the FARC.
There are 200 million people living on $2 per day or less in Latin America. That's 200 million out of 500 million people.
Poverty is a symptom of the problems of Latin America, including corruption. One of the reasons why people are poor is because of corruption, but there are others. There's lack of opportunity, lack of mobility. In fact, Latin America today is in danger of becoming the worst continent next to Africa for social mobility and economic upward mobility. People are stuck in the in levels of poverty and they cannot get out. And that's where the demagogues like Hugo Chavez or Evo Morales or others appeal to them.
It's going to be very difficult to bring about consolidated democracies in Latin America if Latin American countries do not first address the problem of inequality.
Most of these messianic leaders become dictators, eliminate democratic institutions, and try to stay in power indefinitely. They repress all political dissent and exclude significant portions of society from decision-making.